Luna, congratulations. You're staying another week, which means Naomi, I'm so sorry, but it looks like your time is up on this race.
So last week I was eliminated, which I totally agree with because my snatch game and my runway, to be fair, were just not as good as everyone else's. So, but I just want to take like a minute to thank everyone for just like allowing me to be on the race to begin with, and just like thanking the judges for being so like kind and constructive. Because a lot of the things I've said, I'm gonna like carry on and continue to do. To all of the girls, just keep doing you. You might win challenges, you might not. Most of you probably won't. But yeah. Thanks. Bye. Love you all.
So last week on Game of Drag, it was the snatch game, and I thought I should have got first place, but it's okay.
It is week six, and Naomi just went home. I kind of expected it this week because I feel like out of all the looks, hers was not the strongest.
Naomi went home last challenge, and I hate to say it, but I'm not surprised at all. I kind of saw it coming. I don't think she was robbed. She was safe a lot. I love her, but she was safe a lot, so eventually she had to go.
No, I totally think Cece deserved that win. It was the first thing she's ever created. She didn't rely on her closet of dresses. And I do agree with the bottom two and also with who went home. I do miss Naomi, but she was next to go. She was the one who should have gone from that challenge.
It was kind of basic at this point in the competition.
I think my snatch game was the funniest there, and I was really proud of it, and I really wanted to win. Like, I care about this competition, I want to do well in it, and that was like probably my last chance to even win a challenge, so.
I'm glad I chose Trixie as the person to do because her makeup is so completely opposite of what I do. Though it is the whole Barbie-esque kind of like theme, whatever, it was still completely different from what I do.
I did all right. I think I got like third or fourth place, and I can't say I'm surprised. I can't say I'm disappointed. I'm content with what I got. One thing that I'm a little annoyed about though is how some of the judges didn't know who I was playing for the snatch game. Like, I told them who I was playing, and I kind of assumed that they were like search it up, like find out information on the character. And some of them were saying I had no idea who you were playing.
So I actually feel like I'm in the competition now because I have a win under my belt, and I proved everyone wrong that I am not basic and that I can win challenges and that I have a chance at going to the top three. So this week the theme was a reveal.
The concept I had, if it turns out how I want it to turn out, it'll be extremely great. But if not, which right now I'm thinking it probably won't turn out how I want it to, It's just gonna be a little bit of a mess.
It sucks because I, like most other competitions I do, I came into this for validation because I want to feel like I can do things with my drag. I want to feel like people will like what I do and appreciate what I do, and to be the only person in this at this point in the competition with no challenge wins, who's lost on this challenge and like terrified that they're gonna go home. It's not fun.
This week we had a reveal look, and honestly I'm kind of proud of it, but at the same time I'm not really, like, I'm just like, eh. I still am not really liking some of the girls there. Not like liking them as like a person, but liking what they're doing, because, you know, say this, but they just keep wanting to quit, and it, like, I'm not trying to be rude or anything, but if we're gonna quit, just quit.
I feel like it's not enough, you know?
I want to win, and though I probably won't, but I really want to, I'm still here to win.
And I almost dropped out this week because of that. I'm glad I stayed.
This next challenge is just a runway, and it is reveals, and I'm really excited about that because it's very, like, open to whatever interpretation you wanna. I hate when I, like, have to, like, specifically, like, be a pinup girl, you know, like, I don't know. I feel like I would have a lot of room for creativity with this, and I'm really excited to see what I'll do.
I really don't want to go home. This competition has been my life for the past, like, 5 months. I've devoted so much time, so much effort into it. I know at the beginning I was weak and I was just doing not so interesting looks, but I feel like I stepped it up a lot, and I'm excited for everybody to see what I have to bring.
I can't help but feel that Eddie was robbed last challenge. Like, I don't know, I thought he sort of won, you feel, you know?
Hi everyone, and welcome to Game of Drag Episode 7, which is a reveal runway. I challenge the girls to have 2 fully realized looks in the style of a reveal. First up is Luna, and I actually really like this. Because when you first came out, I imagine you just, like, standing by a subway, waiting for your train to come, and you're just like... And I think the reveal was well hidden, and it did have two fully realized different looks with it. Though they were simple, I still did enjoy the two looks, and as always, your makeup is breathtaking, and I think it really showed this week.
Luna, so I really appreciated the concept that you had this week. I think that you served two solid, complete looks. I just wish that you had pushed them farther. Both of the looks were fairly basic, and although it did get your point across really well, I would like to see more accessorization from you.
When I saw the theme, daytime New Yorker to nighttime New Yorker, I expected you, when you were pulling down that dress, to be in a, like, hooker outfit. It was kind of just changing from a red dress to a black dress. Like, even if you were just, like, in panties and a bra, it would have been... Well, I guess that's just getting naked. But if you had been in, like, short shorts, and you were, like, in a bra, and you were, like, had a cigarette, you'd, like, picked up a cigarette or something, I think that would have been better, because they're kind of the same look, just in two different colors.
Up next, we have Candace Cherry, and this is really fun for me, because the first look was, like, a cartoon-like Confederate leader, and then you took off the jacket, which you handmade, I'm very impressed by that, and you took it all off and had the little Simpsons dress with the blue coat, and it was really cute. The only downside would be, I know this is hard to do with a reveal look, but I wish both of them had more of a shape to it, but other than that, it was amazing.
So Candace, you gave us two very, very different, very interesting looks this week. I don't necessarily know what concept you were going for because there didn't seem to be a lot of relation between the two, but they were both unique, interesting, and fully realized looks, which I always appreciate.
Okay, you were my favorite this week. Both looks were very original, very good, very well executed. It was a very clean reveal. You did fidget a little bit, but I don't really care because both looks were amazing. The Simpsons look had me goddamn shook. It's one of my favorite looks that I've seen this season. I was getting a kind of like Confederate soldier vibe with the other look, and I thought it was a good contrast. I've seen your Simpson look on your Instagram, and I did not see it coming. I didn't. I loved it. I loved both looks. You were my favorite this week.
Trixie Hayes. Alright, so I really wish you got closer up to the camera because I couldn't see your face at all. I didn't know if you had some sort of special marking on it. But I did see that it was Egyptian inspired. When you took off your first outfit, I really wish you would have just kept the green dress that you had on. I wish you kept that on, because underneath it was the sticks and twigs, and I didn't understand that, really. The blood was a good touch, though. I don't know how it went with anything, but I wasn't expecting it at all.
Trixie, so this week I really liked the pantsuit to the green sequiny outfit reveal. I don't think it was necessary to pull off that extra fabric for when you did the blood drip effect. I also felt like the peacock feathers that you had tucked into your panties were a little distracting. They weren't full enough to be their own center of attention, but they kind of just made it look clustered. I think the blood drip and kind of the Egyptian eye that you did was really cool. I think you just needed to edit it down a little bit this week.
Okay, I thought your runway was okay. I loved the fabric of the second part. I love that shiny stuff. I thought you could have just left it on, though. You do this thing where you rip off whatever you're wearing. I think this is either the second or third time you've done it in a runway, and it's only, like, the sixth challenge, I think. That's, like, a third of every runway. Just keep it on, because I liked it on better than off.
Rochi, let's start off with your first, look, because you had many reveals in this. I really like this. I think your makeup was different. Your hair, I really liked. I've obviously done something like it before. And I thought the dress worked. But throughout all of your reveals, there was like a lump in there. And I know you had a lot packed in there, but you could have minimized it so much to make it more solid, because it was very lumpy in the middle. And until you took it off, I was not enjoying the looks. But the final look, when you were completely bald, That was amazing. I think you stepped it up this week.
Roshi, so you had a really interesting take on this challenge. I don't know that you necessarily had a concept going into this. I like that you did three separate reveals. However, I was not a fan of the bald, especially because you could see the bald cap and your hair sticking out the back of it. You also had this weird kind of pregnancy belly lump for a lot of your runway, which I know was the final dress being hidden under it, but I just feel like that wasn't executed the best. I found myself staring at the lump that you were trying to cover with your hands more than I was looking at your outfit. So if you're gonna do a reveal, it needs to be a solid look before that, and having a giant bulge of fabric, I wouldn't say is a solid look.
I thought you were on the higher end of the spectrum, but I thought that there was too many reveals. You do this thing where you go above and beyond, and I mean, always do your best, but it's kind of getting, I mean, maybe it's just me, but it's kind of getting to be too much now. It's almost showboating, and not in a good way, but I think you did good. I loved the avant-garde theme because it's something we haven't seen from you, but you also, the like, just black and white was kind of basic, and the reveals were kind of like, it was just kind of like holding things in place, like the pants drop, you were just holding them, and you just spread your legs. Like, I would have liked a little bit more mechanics behind it. I did like the reveal to the black two-piece, I think. That was good. I think you did good, though. I love the hair, the wig reveal. I think you were the only queen that did a wig reveal, though.
Cece, you've proven yourself that you can make an outfit out of duct tape from last week. But carrying over to this week, I think you chose a little bit more challenging of an outfit to do. The back of it, it was a little plain, but the circus, I think, added to it. The circus letters could have been so much neater. I know that can happen with duct tape. And the back looks a little rushed, but when you flipped over, I was like, oh, okay, that's a lot better than the back. But as much as I really like this look, there's no reveal to it. It was just you turning around, and I don't think that fits the challenge at all.
Cece, when you told me about your concept this week, I was super excited to see what you did because it sounded like a really great idea. Unfortunately, I don't really like this execution very much. It's pretty much a bed sheet draped over you, and the reveal is just you turning around. I mentioned before that I was looking for two separate full looks in this challenge, and I don't feel like I even really got one full look from you. I don't see this as a wearable outfit.
Okay, honey. The point of a reveal runway is not to just reveal something, it's to have two fully realized looks in one. You have one fully realized look, and then you reveal a second fully realized look. You only had one look. You just revealed that you were a clown. Which, if it was an do something out of the box challenge, you would have gotten an A+. This is so out of the box for you. Your makeup was so out of the box. You made it. I loved it. It wasn't a challenge.
Paprika, your presentation is always on point, but because it's just a coat and you wouldn't really wear that as an actual finished look. Candace made her coat this week, which is why it was acceptable. And I can see you put the effort into the target dress, but the coat wasn't exactly a reveal in itself.
I actually really enjoyed this look this week. You started your runway as like a rich bitch in her expensive furs, just come back from shopping, and then you revealed into this like Target shopping bag dress, which was just like so cheap in comparison to the beginning of your runway that it worked. I mean, it was two full looks. The dress was wearable. It was tacky, but that's kind of the point. I liked it. I really enjoyed your look this week.
Happy. I loved the whole like shopper to shopping bag. Like, that was out of all the like themes, that was my favorite one because it was just so adorable. But I will say it was kind of just opening a jacket. It's about as much of a reveal as Candace's, so I'm sorry, I'm just realizing this now. I mean, I guess with limited resources, you did really good.
Alright, Candace, Roshi, and Luna, you three are the top three of this week. Congratulations. Trixie Hayes, you are safe. which means Paprika and Cece. Sorry, but you two will be the bottom two today. The winner of this challenge is Candace Cherry. Congratulations on your third win. Paprika, it was wonderful having you on, but it looks like your time is up here. This sucks to do, and know that we all love you here, and we hope that you return sometime.